welcome. This is Rochelle from the DIY Affiliate, and thank you for stopping by my channel, and thank you for checking out this video. This is the video number 2 in creating a Facebook business page, in which I will be showing you an overview of a brief overview of the Canva and how to create your profile picture using Canva, and how to create your cover picture using Canva, and then adding it to your Facebook. So stick around, I give you just the facts. Let's get into the video. We are over at Facebook right now. This is the new page, and here you will find your profile photo, and here you will find your cover photo. If you go over to canva.com, start a free account today, and here you have many choices. All different types of social media posts that you can make. You can make YouTube thumbnails, and here is where I created the profile and also the cover. Once you start your free account, we will start with the profile. First of all, you need to have the size of 180 by 180. This is 180 by 180 pixels. And here I have used text just by click add to the page, and then copy and paste your text into the editing box that you will see for text. And here you can use different fonts, sizes, and you can change your text color simply by choosing another color. You can bold, use italics, align to the left, align to the right, and justify. You can also use bullets, and this is your letter spacing. Effects, and if you click into these three dots, you will see you can copy, you can use a transparency, you can use the uppercase, and you can also use the underline. The position. And this is where it appears on the page: the top, the left, the middle, center, bottom, and right, and forward and backwards. So what that means is this is now, if I move this down, this is on top. If I click on the backwards, this will go behind. And always know where your undo arrow is. Then when you are done, you click on the downward arrow, and I would choose a JPG, and then download to your computer to be uploaded to your Facebook. So this was creating your profile very easily. And if you don't want to use what is called an element, you have a choice. You could also use any of your uploads. You could use photos. And here in the elements, there are different elements that you can use. And as soon as it's uploaded, I will show you. You have many choices. And I have done a few videos on using Canva. I'll leave one in the description. You have your background, and you have your own folders, and then you have more. If you click into more, then you will see the apps and integrations that Canva integrates with, such as YouTube, emojis, Facebook, Instagram. Creating your cover. And here, the best size that I have found is 820 pixels by 300. If you look, it says 820 by 315 pixels, but it all depends on what you want seen and how it is displayed. I have found the 820 by 300 is the best. And you would do the exact same thing here. You could actually choose a template, and you can search in these templates, use any one of these templates simply by clicking into the template. Say I wanted to use this template. I'm just going to add as a new page. So this would be the template that I was using, and here if I wanted to, I could change this text just by typing in it and adding text and deleting text. And I could also make it bigger by using my arrow as well. There's two types of arrows that you can use. These are your editing circles here. When you have the two-headed arrow, this will make your item smaller or bigger to the aspect ratio. So it will remain the same, it'll just get smaller or bigger. When you click into your element, and you have your arrow and you press down, and you get your four-headed arrow. When you get your four-headed arrow, you can move anything around any way that you want. You can move that around. So you can choose a template. You can also use from your uploads. You can use from photos. And there are many photos here. I don't know about you, but when you have a YouTube channel and you're looking for content, this will give you a lot of content. So there's lots of photos here that you can choose from. And then here is your elements. This panel is the exact same as what you will see with your profile picture. So as soon as this is uploaded, I will go through the elements. This is just a brief overview for you. But you want to make your cover picture appealing. You want to make it so that people are interested in your page. So you have lines, you have shapes, you have frames, you have stickers, and stickers will come out as little videos. You have charts, grids, zodiac signs, simple drawn objects, camping rustic drawings, sketchy flowers. You have many different choices, and even with the free account, you do have a lot of choice. Also, I'm looking for 4 people to add to my team. People who are either on YouTube or other social media platforms, and you need to make content. I can help you to do that, and I'd like to add you to my team. Canva has a special where I can add 4 people for free to my team. If you're interested, leave me a comment down below this video. And here is videos. If you want to add a video and more folders and more. So this is what I like about Canva Pro. This is Canva Pro that you are looking at right now. And if you want to work with me, become one of my team members, then you will be able to work with this Canva Pro. YouTube. Do you have a YouTube channel? I'm just going to type in my channel here, DIY Affiliate. And here I can add any one of my videos just by clicking in my video. It will then be added to this canvas right here. And once it is added, when I click into the video, you will see the circle with the line, and here it has your video URL. This is how you would create ebooks with using your videos from your YouTube channel, and I will be going over that in another video. This is just a very brief overview for you. Okay, so anyways, I am going to download the first page because this is the one that I am using. And I like the JPG. If you ever want to create a Kindle book, you will be using the JPG and not the PNG. And then download. Ouch! Ouchie! I got a new kitten and it likes attacking me with his teeth. He likes attacking me with his little teeth. Yes, you like attacking me with your little teeth. Ow, ow, ow. I know I don't have my camera on right now, so you can't really see him. He's such a cutie, though. He's like a, I don't know, he just likes to bite. Yeah, he likes biting. Okay, so they continue editing. And now we would go over to our Facebook. And here, when you want to add your cover, you would click Edit. And here is your choice. You can choose from videos, you can choose from photos, you can create a slideshow, or you can upload a video. For the purpose of this video, we are going to click on Upload a Video. There is my video right there. You will see it gets uploaded. And you can drag it around to position it to where you want it to be, and then click on Save Your Changes. If you choose to create a slideshow, you would just click on Create Slideshow. And here you can add more photos. You can choose from your photos or you can upload a photo. I'm just going to choose from my photos. Say I wanted to add another photo, this would then appear here and continue on and on. You would be able to add 5 different photos. You would have to make sure they're 820 by 300. I'm just going to cancel this. Ow! Stop. You always have to have a toy or something for him to play with, because otherwise he'll be biting you or scratching you. It's hard to make a video while you're playing with a kitten. Okay. Play with your toy for a minute. Alright, so now with your profile, you would just click into this right here, and you would look at Edit Profile Picture, View Profile Picture. I'm just going to edit this profile picture because I would like to add the profile picture. When you choose Edit, you can then upload another profile picture and then choose from what you have uploaded. I'm just going to not choose any, well, basically what you would do is you would just click in the upload photo and it will open up to your file manager. You would then choose your picture that you want and upload it. And here you can make it bigger. See, this is another thing that I just wanted to mention very quickly. I'm just going to discard that right now. One thing that I wanted to mention, do you see how it crops this? And you have your words inside. You need to make sure when you are creating your profile picture that you have your words inside the cropped circle so that they show up when your profile picture is cropped. So this video was about creating your cover and also creating your profile picture. The first video was about creating your page and adding your title, your categories, and your descriptions. And I will leave that, the link, in the description. If you have found this video helpful, then please give this video a thumbs up and click the notification bell so that you will be notified of the next video that I post as I go through this series of doing a Facebook business page. I'm looking forward to hanging out with you in the next video in which I will be showing you how to add this button. Stay safe and have a wonderful evening.